Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station update. On board the International Space Station, the six Expedition 32 crew members are halfway through their day. As they have this entire week, all members of the crew spent time today preparing for one spacewalk or another. Of course, the first in line is the Russian spacewalk, scheduled to start at 9:40 a.m. Central Time on Monday. Commander Gennady Padalka and Flight Engineer Yuri Malenchenko are going to be going out of the Pier's docking compartment on the Russian side of the station and spending 6.5 hours on a variety of tasks. The primary one is the relocation of the Strela 2 crane from the Pier's to the Zarya module to get ready for the replacement of the Pier's with the Russian multi-purpose laboratory module scheduled to come up to the station next year. Padalka and Malenchenko, with help from Flight Engineer Sergei Revin, are spending their day making final preparations for that spacewalk. They put on the Orlan Russian spacesuits that they're going to be wearing on Monday to perform a fit check. And Revin also went through some checkouts of the communication channels that they'll be using. Again, that spacewalk is scheduled to begin at 9:40 a.m. Central Time on Monday. And NASA TV coverage of the event will start at 9 a.m. On the U.S. side of the station, the spacewalk is a bit further away. It's scheduled for August 30th, but preparations are also well underway there. Flight Engineer Sonny Williams and Aki Hoshide are going to be performing that spacewalk, which will also last 6.5 hours, and its primary task is going to be the replacement of a main bus switching unit that's expected to fail before too long. Williams and Hoshide are spending much of their afternoon reviewing procedures for the excursion, and Flight Engineer Joe Acapa is joining in, going over his duties, choreographing the spacewalk from inside the station. Crew still managing to squeeze in plenty of scientific work today, too, though. Flight Engineer Joe Acapa began the day working on the BCAT experiment. That's binary colloidal alloy test, which is studying nanoscale particles dispersed in liquids. Those are the colloidal suspensions. And they're often used in paints, electronic polishing compounds, and food products. Acapa then moved from that onto the advanced colloids experiment, which takes advantage of the space station's environment to study flow characteristics, evolution, and ordering effects in colloidal materials and microgravity. And he also spent some time changing out a cable on the fluid integrated rack that provided white light to the facility's microscope. Williams and Hoshide were both scheduled to spend some more time on the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which looks at how astronauts' hearts change after spending long times in macrogravity. And in addition, Williams performed some troubleshooting on the Isaac experiment. That's the International Space Station Agricultural Camera, which is used to take images in visible and infrared lights of crops, grasslands, and forest, primarily in the northern Great Plains region of the U.S., and then also more generally to study dynamic Earth processes around the world, such as melting glaciers, ecosystem responses to seasonal changes, and human impacts, and natural disasters. Once Williams had the laptop back up and running, the team here on the ground was able to get it set up to photograph areas in Russia and Argentina today. And Hoshini also took part in the circadian rhythms and procate dietary study. The former looks at how living through 16 sunrises and sunsets a day affects astronauts, and the latter studies whether diet can be used to counter bone loss in microgravity. In addition to all this, on the Russian side of the station, Sergei Revin also found time to work on the SINER experiment, which works to identify current bioproductive areas in the world's ocean. It's been a busy day and a busy week for the crew on board the International Space Station, with lots of interesting work going on. This is Mission Control, Houston.